A wise man once said that people without knowledge of their history, origin, and culture are like trees without roots. Well, the city of Murfreesboro took those words to heart and created a special place to honor its roots. It's called Cannonsburg. And Ricky Chick, the latest member of our Crossroads family, takes us there.
All right, if you'll just follow the lady with the sign, we'll go right through here and we'll go in through the gate.
There's a magical place in Murfreesboro where a quick turn off the busiest street in town also turns back the pages of time. The historic village of Cannonsburg has been a part of the Murfreesboro Parks Department for nearly 50 years, but the buildings that make it so special have been around much longer than that, as Parks Director Nate Williams explains.
In 1974, the city embarked on a national bicentennial project. You know, the whole nation was celebrating, encouraged communities across the United States to do something that would be unique to mark the bicentennial of the United States. So leaders with Murfreesboro at that time decided to create this village, bring in buildings from across the county from the late 1800s to early 1900s. And it ended up winning a national award, third place in the country, ended up winning $75,000. And an interesting fact, it's the only one of these projects that's still around today.
Part of the reason Cannonsburg is still around can be attributed to a devoted staff and volunteers, time-traveling tour guides like Kathy Owen, who bring the village to life.
A lot of them are folks that came on tours with their grandchildren and became interested in the place and said, hey, what can I do? And we have several that are retired teachers, and they love it.
Throughout our park system, we have tons of volunteers. We recognize them every year, and Cannonsburg is a huge percentage of that. They come out and they bring their expertise and their passion for these buildings in this area. We can't say enough how much we appreciate all they do to make this village what it is.
What in the world have we got here? I've been looking for some desperados.
You got them, man.
Man, this is a desperate looking crew if I ever did see one. I'm also not only the marshal this here, Cannonsburg, I'm the truancy officer,
But Marshall, these kids are in school. What better way to learn than by immersing them in a bygone era, surrounded by actual buildings and artifacts from Rutherford County's past?
We do a lot of school tours. So when we have the school tours lined up, I'm the one that kind of organizes and gets the kids started. I generally start with the mill. There were a lot of mills in this area. The equipment in the mill is over 100 years old, and it actually does work. The schoolhouse is very interesting. It's set up as a conscription school, and the people that lived in the community would pay the teachers to come in, and the teachers would actually take turns living with the different families. That seems to be the favorite thing of a lot of the children on the tour, and it's real different for them. That seems to be one of their favorites. It's interesting, you know, I always try to ask them what's missing from the buildings, the children. And first off, they'll say a computer. Then they'll finally come to the fact that there's no bathroom. But they seem to like the parts that they're not even familiar with.
A telephone switchboard certainly falls into that category, like the one in Miss Ada's house.
It was the home of Miss Ada Rowland. She was employed by a private telephone company. She came as a widow with a young child. We actually have her original switchboard and battery cabinet. She was on call 24 hours a day and actually knew everything that happened in the community before anybody else.
Wouldn't that be a dream job for the town gossip? Listening to Kathy, it's easy to tell that she's found her dream job as well.
So Kathy, tell me about the Lehman House.
The Lehman House is my personal favorite. It was actually located outside of Murfreesboro. There were 10 children raised here, 5 boys and 5 girls. They had a rather large farm, tobacco and cattle raisers. And we are lucky enough to have some of the family that still comes around and can share stories of Thanksgiving and all sorts of things.
Any idea what this is?
Most visitors don't know what this is, but back in the day, for those of us who were vertically challenged, it was a very handy device. It's a mounting block, and it was used so women could mount their horses.
And when those horses needed shoes, where did they go? The local blacksmith, of course.
The interesting thing about steel, see the magnet sticks to the steel, but when it gets to critical temperature, that orange hot, it doesn't stick anymore.
Now, if you prefer horseless carriages, you can check out the classic cars at the Stones River Garage. But beware, it's a speed trap. Must be related to that Marshall.
And this is just a great place for people to come and pause for a second and reflect on more simple times.
You might have heard your grandparents tell you about it, but if you come here, you really get to experience it for just a little while. It's a taste of a life that doesn't really exist anymore.
Except in a magical place, near a busy street, in the borough.